Dank für die Einführung.
Many thanks for the introduction, Professor Matschulat.
As Professor Matschulat asked,
against the background of the June flood in 2013, we were pleased to accept the offer to hold a speech here. And I want to speak about the management of dams by elevations. It's a compromise between quantities and qualities, especially in terms of extreme events, specifically flood risks and also the quality impact of floods.
Auch wir sind wie der Staatsbetrieb Sachsen-Forst.
Like Saxon Forest, we are a state enterprise. We are concerned, vulnerable. We have to be able to cope with the impact of the climate change, and we have our own observations. And for quality management, we have here statistics, the ice break.
Tag des Eisaufbruches und den Tag der Sommerstagnation.
Day of ice break and the day of summer stagnation. This is the day in the year where we have a clear stratification in the reservoir with clear water in the bottom and where we deliver the waterworks. You see the statistical values since 1970. We have a clear bend in the curve between 1981 and 1991. This was a shift of ice break earlier in the year, and also summer stagnation had a shift towards earlier in the year. It's not about the political change we had in this period, but it coincides very well with what we read for the general period between 1990 and early 21st century. The general warming up. As to the geographic situation, Sosa Reservoir is around 400 both meters elevation. This is a preliminary remark.
Ganz kurz die Aufgaben der Landestalsperrenverwaltung
vorstellen. I'd like to summarize the task we have as a state reservoir administration. Then I will speak about the integral management of reservoirs in terms of flood in contrast with dry periods. Will there be more tension in the future? And what, according to the climate models, and how do we actually prepare for the projected impacts? Then I will draw conclusions, and in the second part I will discuss the Reclam findings. So far for the beginning, we were founded in 1992 as LTV, State Reservoir Administration, same year as Saxon Forest. We are attached to this, we report to the State Ministry for Environment and Agriculture. There are legal regulations directly applicable to us. Raw water preparation, I will not speak about that. This is not actually quoted like this in the regulation, but we actually build and operate, we design, build and operate the stagnating water bodies and 300 kilometers of flowing water bodies of the first order, as it is called in the law, 300 kilometers of border water bodies and 640 meters of dams. And when adding up all this, then we have 140 impoundment installations with 23 drinking water reservoirs which supply the water to the waterworks of the municipalities. Climate projection over the past 2 days, we heard a lot about this, temperatures increasing, more evaporation, part reduction in rainfall. There are differences between East and West Saxony and between winter and summer. Is there an increase in extreme events? It is being discussed. It seems probable according to the physical relationships, but it cannot be seen directly from the climate models. But we will have to reckon with longer and more extreme droughts, more heavy rainfalls, warmer winters, and in the end we will have we will be faced with quality problems due to the impacts mentioned. 40% of the drinking water in Saxony is generally drawn from reservoirs, like here, even 70% in the region of Chemnitz, which is the closest big city.
So,
how will be the contrast in the future? Retention grow higher. Let's first of all ask, what's the task of dams? They were built for collecting water, for drinking water, industrial water and flood control. These two pillars, water supply and flood control, was always part of the reservoirs. Our oldest dates back to 1894 here in the region, Rheinsiedel, close to Chemnitz. Then, of course, hydropower and low-level regulation and recreation these years are other factors. They always had supra-regional importance and were multifunctional in use.
Here in Saxony,
they were created in the Erzgebirge region, in regions where groundwater was not so abundant, in order to have waters by collection of river water and stream water. There are many people around reservoirs. We have a conflict of interest outside, but also internally, because there is a massive conflict of interest between flood protection and drinking water supply. Why? Very simply, an empty reservoir would be very good for flood control, but we can no longer supply any drinking water. So we have to find a compromise, and in 2003 it was discussed because of the big flood which occurred in 2002. All our flood control area, risk areas were extended larger, and we had also impact assessments, also impact on the quality of groundwaters and reservoir waters, and so we upgraded our reservoirs in the wake of the events. Dr. Sieger, the head of the LTV at the time, made this diagram, which dates back to 2003 and illustrates this conflict. Will this conflict grow in the future? And we cannot tell, frankly. Why not? There are a lot of models, climate models, which are used. The output is has a big spread as to the possible results, and there are different scenarios behind. But we have the consensus that warming up below 1.8 degrees is not probable, and we cannot exclude warming up above 6 degrees Celsius. We are here at this point in 2010, this is the red line. There are still several years, and then we will see what the actual output will be.
From Saxenfurt,
we heard, what is our orientation? Will we actually come up to the extremes, or will we remain in the better risk levels? What should we prepare? Let's look back first of all. I'd like to explain the basic model. We have a dam, we have a bottom outlet, also river outlet and a municipal outlet, and we have a spillway and overflow. We have certain pools, pool levels. We have the inactive storage pool, which is the absolute minimum. Then we have an active conservation pool up to a impoundment target, and then we have the flood control storage capacity reaching up to the overflow. The spillway looks like this. This is Eibenstock, our largest reservoir in 2002. In 2013 as well, we had this picture in reality. The overflow of a reservoir is a planned management case. Even if there is spill, the dam still retains water. We call it extraordinary flood control storage. We still have the river outlet, and normally this is spillway and river outlet on the bottom are the two maximum minimum controls.
und meinetwegen auch an Brauchwasserindustrie.
Which is also important for supply of processed water, industrial water.
But
drinking water is no longer possible at lower level.
Lichtenberg in Juni 2013,
in Juni 2013, this reservoir, we see the turbidity which was caused by the June flood water. The first samples were unaffected, then the flood control storage pool had to be released, removed,
Niederschläge ankündigt.
Because new precipitation
Lichtenberg
was announced.
Über keine weiteren
Lichtenberg has no further
und was passiert, wenn wir die
installations.
Über den
what can we do? We can use the river outlet,
but then
all the turbidity will be drawn to the bottom.
Das konnten wir machen, weil
we could do this because the Lichtenberg reservoir has a diversion channel, diversion tunnel, gallery, which could be used.
Aber das als Beispiel,
we could do this at a specific point,
but zur Verfügung hat.
This shows the problem around the bottom outlet,
ja.
The river
so
outlet,
kam es auch.
At lowest
Diesmal
levels.
Die Wetterprognose
and then the weather forecast was right. On the 9th of June 2013, almost 80 liters per square meter was the precipitation rate, rainfall, hailfall, so to say, 9th of June, like
was
snow.
Mit der Wassergüte? Nun, den ersten Einbruch
was the water quality?
So
I already saw, showed turbidity, which was drawn down. You see the sample points, sample elevations,
Einheiten, also die
and you see the units, the bacteria counts, which were also drawn downwards to the bottom and caused big, huge problem for the waterworks. Then there was settling. And later in June, we had rainfalls, heavy rainfalls, again turbidity increase at the top, and the bacteria count was quite constant. But several days after this, the reservoir could resume service as normal. So for quality management and quality control, we need more than just a bottom outlet. We need an extended model design with a pre-dam, several extraction points, epilimnic discharges. That means that we can the surface water can be discharged. We would need diversion channels, bypasses, and we would need control. It's like a Mercedes among dams, the Phaeton among dams, as we say in Saxony, where the Phaeton is built. An example for the Phaeton is Klingenberg. I showed it already in the introductory picture. You see here the diversion from around the pre-dam. You see the pre-dam, which was built a bit larger, whereas the Klingenberg, while the reservoir Klingenberg was emptied in order for reconstruction, then the Dresden waterworks was supplied with the water from the pre-dam, not discharged, as was misspelling. So it was an upgrading construction of waterworks of Dresden in Koschitz gets the water from the reservoir. That's why the pre-dam was made with the gates loose. So the pre-dam is filled up to this point, but, and this is the Phaeton among, it can actually be lowered in order to collect water, then the sediments will settle down, and all comes that comes from the catchment area could be streamed around by the diversion channel. So it's not only for quality management, but also for flood control, because after 2002, new models were developed or discussed. A 10,000-year event should be accepted or absorbed, controlled by a dam, and that is why we had to upgrade it. We had to upgrade the existing flood control facilities, but as we did not comply with the regulation, that is why this diversion gallery was included, this diversion tunnel, but which is actually a very good thing for quality control. Another possibility would be to discharge water at the top. Again, a stratification, warm waters on top and cold water down to the bottom, very important for waterworks, raw water discharge in blue, as you can see.
And
then the metalimnic area would be the input area. Turbidity would remain there with bacteria and all what comes from the catchment area into the reservoir pool, and in order to release the water in the flood control storage space,
we should
be able to discharge it. This is a special spillway. It's not the overflow, but it's a gate sluice, a sluice gate, which we see here,
sozusagen den Hochwasserschutzraum,
which is able to release the water from the flood control storage room, and we do not need to pull down to draw down the turbidity which accumulates in the top surface. You see, I jump from one reservoir to the other, and that's why let's come to the Eibenstock reservoir. I selected it because in 2002, again, we had a similar diagram which had been published all over Saxony. You see turbidity accumulating on the top, and we were able to discharge it on top, but via spillways, not via the new sluice gate,
der Stadt Chemnitz,
in order to have appropriate water for Chemnitz, for the city of Chemnitz. This is the diagram of 2002, it's the same picture more or less.
So
we have gained the knowledge in Klingenberg, and during the reconstruction of other reservoirs, we actually introduced these findings into the actual design. As conclusion, turbidity is normally is a normal impact, more organic matter, turbidity, stain, color, we have phosphorus inputs, lower nitrate, electric conductivity, and in water catchment areas we have rain water overflows and runoffs, which all should not be part of the flood water.
So
in the wake of floods, we have impact on the quality of water. These are the inputs from top, more algae, and lack of oxygen in the lower
strata.
And this is our stress because of more consumption of oxygen in the water, algae formation due to other light conditions. During the past few years, we saw algae species which we had never seen before. So there are biological explosions which we cannot actually reckon with because we do not know what the actual effects and weighting factors are. Technical facilities are very important, especially in the top sections of the reservoirs. If there are alternative lines or sources of raw water, they should be retained. So Rauschenbach, for example, has a reservoir, and as a secondary reservoir could be used. Diversion facilities, we have it in Karlsfeld and in Werda, as well as in Klingenberg, and these are old ones in the other two. So in Werda, it's a very old facility and was very favorable when we had the latest flood in 2013. An automatic instrumentation for operative management is very useful, but of course you have a high need for maintenance, so transmitters and sensors need to be cleaned, and the values measured need to be verified. It's not entirely automatic, by the way.
Risk,
cost, benefit, alternatives, all that has to be balanced and has to be adapted to each other. Let's come to the second part. These are the findings of the Reclam project.
sozusagen die technischen Systeme der Trinkwasseraufbereitung,
the technical systems of water preparation, water treatment in terms of the climate change are robust already. This was a good result of the project.
Auch hier wird ausführlich darauf eingegangen, dass wir mit einer ansteigenden Variabilität hinsichtlich
higher variability in terms of volume
zu rechnen
and matter composition has to be reckoned with and adaptation measures need to be taken.
Daher sind unter Ziel 212
Maßnahmen zu target for 2012 measure 2.12
use von Talsperren können wir ausführen, dass wir zusammen mit den Wasserversorgern
a guarantee of water supplies in terms of compensation payments. We make compensation payments for farmers. They get compensation for intermediary crops after the main harvest in order to be sure that the fields are always cultivated. And of course, erosion-prone areas should be tilled in a conservative way to protect it. And manure is forbidden in the protection zone. And also fertilizers, the use of fertilizers. This is, these are two diagrams, graphs. Maybe it's difficult to read on the left-hand side. We see nitrate concentrations, nitrate levels in the drinking water reservoirs, in the names just given. There was an increase until 1990-1991, and then we have a steady decrease in nitrate, although around in the environment we did not exceed 20 milligrams per liter, weighted mean. Very often we are below, despite intensive agriculture. Why? We had a political turn. The large animal husbandry facilities were no longer used, were closed down. And this was a very big factor, and fertilizers became more expensive,
so
the farmers, farming associations were restructured, farmers restructured the legal situation. And what is interesting, also in the forest areas, we had a decrease in nitrates, nitrate levels. Possibly it's in the, or probably it's inside the trees, because they use it as nutrient and fructify and grow. As we heard,
zur Anpassung der Mengen- und Gütebewirtschaftung von
measures, adaptation to higher temperatures,
wenn es zu Sauerstoffziehung im Tiefenwasser kommt,
können wir technisch oxygen consumption in lower strata, we have countermeasures, we actually introduce oxygen, pure oxygen, in order to avoid iron, manganese and other elements.
Ist keine Sanierungsmaßnahme, sondern
it's no renovation, but it's a symptomatic treatment, so to say.
Chemische Sedimentstabilisierung wurde
sedimental, chemical sediment stabilization for industrial waters or high eutrophy waters with a lot of sediments, it might be useful, but it should not be used in drinking water reservoirs, because the whole chemistry would be disturbed.
Sehr stark hier mit dem Wasserversorger zusammenarbeiten.
Or you should, in any case, you should work closely together with Waterworks. So, and various elevation horizons.
Wurde genannt. Das ist ein
integrated time dynamic
leidiges Thema.
Volumes and quality management.
Fließgewässer der ersten Ordnung
we are responsible for first order water bodies, flowing water bodies, but the tributaries of the second order is not our responsibility, which are the rivers here. We try to tackle this,
and we try
to buy, but we do not have a preemptive option in order to buy first. So private owners can actually remain forest managers and foresters in the surrounding of a reservoir. It's not possible to buy all for the state, because we would need to buy more land.
Sparsamer Umgang mit Brauch und Trinkwasser, das
to save waters,
gestattet,
so consumption savings in terms of processed water, industrial water and drinking water, we should save the resource drinking water, because this will help minimize the resource and spare the resource in total. This is basically correct,
but
it's basically true for the groundwater. For surface waters, it is not necessary, because we have high capacities for water supplies.
And the water supply and discharge systems
are actually designed for peak times. So water savings
would
not reduce the fixed costs for the facilities. We have the fixed costs, they are high.
And
if there are savings on behalf of the consumers, we will be faced with other problems. So I ask everybody, use your water, actually open the tap. You can drink the water coming from the taps here in Saxony, no problem. Do not save too much, because Saxony is one of the regions with lowest consumption rates of water, of drinking water from tap, of tap water.
Ja, mit dieser Folie möchte ich mich verabschieden.
This is the last picture I would like to use to say goodbye to you.
This
is the compromise, the conflict, the new heat record. Doctor says, we see on the tongue, this is a new heat record. Many thanks for your attention.
Ganz herzlichen Dank, Ralf.
Many thanks, Ralf.
Das war ein anregender Vortrag,
it was a very interesting, exciting presentation with new aspects integrated into the discussion. What I liked, was astonished most is the comparison with the Phaeton, because I think it's less sustainable than most of your reservoirs. So maybe it was not the best comparison, but however, many thanks for the wonderful complexity and also the interlink between land uses and agriculture and reservoirs. And of course, you're open to discussion.
Wer hat die Mikrofone? Nein, nein, das geht um die Übersetzer, die hören sonst nichts. Und du gehst bitte wieder ins Mikro, sonst hören die auch nicht.
Es war grün. Es ist an. Gut. Ja, mein Name ist Maria Foltin.
I'm Maria Foltin from the Bavarian Agency for Environment.
Vortrag.
Many thanks for your presentation.
So richtig will es nicht. Sie haben uns sehr schön anschaulich gezeigt, was
you
für Qualitätsprobleme
well
jetzt durch
quality problems are due to flood
aber wie wir in
events,
diesem Winter gesehen haben, haben wir auch ein, oder könnte have, auch durchaus ein massives Niedrigwasserproblem auftreten. Können Sie dazu
low
ein paar Worte verlieren, was
could
denn die Herausforderung auch qualitativ für die Trinkwasserversorgung
Niedrigwasserfall
ist?
Water quality supplies in case of low water levels.
And what would you say,
could you say something about what you would do
if
we will continue to have a very dry summer with a lack of water? I actually prepared that in a handwritten version, but I did not use it for the presentation. I think for Annaberger Climate Days, we should remember 2003, which followed the flood year 2002. Same is true for 2014, a dry year after a wetter year. And of course, it has an impact on our active conservation pool elevations, because our design is for the time series before. So two dry summers could be coped with. Then we would have first scarcity, and then we would give a warning.
Also wie gesagt, von der Wassermenge her ist das
as
schon
to
in
the
der
quantities, it's part of the design,
bei der
the management design,
und auch bei der,
for the, for the active conservation pool,
die wir machen.
And also in terms of the management plan. For the water quality, you're right, it's different. We'll have warmer temperatures, higher bacteria count or similar things. I showed the summer stagnation, which has a shift to the earlier period of the year. Das and we will have to live longer from the bottom water.
This has an impact
on water preparation, also on behalf of the water suppliers, water providers, water works. We have a good cooperation. I did not show any longer-term trends, increase of pH, reduction in conductivity. We are closely collaborating with the water works, and they are asking us again and again, what's the orientation? I say, we need quantity to deliver the quality. We do not know what the quantity development will be, but once we know what the quantity is, we know what the quality will be. In terms of volume management, we can cope with two dry summers, two dry years. In terms of quality, we will be faced with problems which we can encounter with certain countermeasures, for example, different elevations for extraction and oxygen introduction.
Wir haben ja in Reklam relativ lang diskutiert, ob wir auch Bewässerung als möglichen Verbraucher einkalkulieren,
whether irrigation should be included in the water consumption rates. Also in terms of drinking water is not an actual problem, but irrigation might be the case. Saxony has the lowest consumption rates.
Die ja vor 30 Jahren durchaus einen höheren Bewässerungsanteil hatte,
agriculture had a higher ratio. Is there more agriculture irrigation as process water, as irrigation water, and uses also drinking water from the reservoir? Does this play a part? Is this part of the projections, of the calculations, of the design? It's also part of the climate change.
So. Könntet ihr bitte von der Technik mal umschalten auf die... Okay, danke. So, wir
machen das jetzt weiter vorne. Auch dafür vielen Dank. Die Folie habe ich eigentlich weggedrückt, weil Landwirtschaft heute noch gar nicht so das große Thema war.
Because agriculture was not part of the main discussion, because there are not many farmers or agriculture-related people here. There are a lot of agricultural reservoirs, which are also part of our facilities, which we are responsible for, if they are actually used for flood control or usable for flood control. Maintenance for these impoundments is done by LTV, our State Reservoir Administration. These facilities are in existence and could be used for irrigation purposes in agriculture. We also have smaller facilities which are not part of our responsibility, municipal reservoirs, impoundment facilities, and which could also be used for irrigation. Investments will be necessary, is another point. But what is our responsibility is available for irrigation and is partly already used for irrigation. We have no, I do not have actual data about how much this is and whether the trend is increasing.
Ich sehe jetzt keine Hand mehr.
I see no hand up. So many thanks, Ralf Sutrak, for your presentation.